All right, Wrigley is clean and dry now. I'm probably gonna have to stop here in a little bit. I've got another dog coming in 25 minutes or so. I wanna get him started while you dry. Get him drying while I finish you. I've got a phone call I gotta make up to the courthouse at 1 o'clock, so. This keeps my mind off that. No, I'm not in trouble. It's about my son's insurance. So we're shaving his feet out now. Wrigley, stop it. You know how this works. Wrigley, no. Seems like these big dogs are always more nosy about what you're doing. Stop. Okay, you want to do it this way? Sit. Sit. Or you can stand. I don't care. Just let me see your foot. Ready? We've done this since you were itty bitty. You know the drill. I hate furry paw dogs. Hate it. No. Got one dog that I've been grooming for 4 years now, and he is still, like, terrible for his feet. He'll let me do his back ones, like shave out his paw pads and everything, but you even look at his front feet and he goes ballistic. And his mom knows, and he's gonna do what you can with his front legs. He's just a little terrier that gets bath and trimmed up a little bit all over. Kidding though, he's sweet and then he turns into hellspawn for his front legs. It's strange. No. Don't be rude. They're nosy. No. Rude. Look away, please. Rude. No. No. Wrigley's still very much a puppy. Stop. No. Stop being so nosy. Stop. Stop. Thank you. There. Was that so bad? No, it was not. Trim up by his eyes again with the pen. Just to even it out. No eye boogers. Good job. We're gonna touch up his sanitary. I haven't done his butt yet. Dogs, you're always so weird about your butts. With your wieners. Stop. Awkward as you make it, dude. I feel like I'm doing a manscape. I'm a dog groomer. There you go. got a mat there and your man parts that I missed earlier. Likes I didn't mess with your balls.
Get one of your dogs here. You can come back here.
Hi, Joe!
Hi, Joe. Look at the puppy. Look at the puppy.
Joe, come here.
Joe, you loved her before.
How much are we taking off of him this time?
Just whatever you want. You did okay. Such a great job the last
time. I was excited when I saw his name on the schedule again.
Joe.
Come here, buddy.
Come on. You'll be fine. And I do have... Well, I'll bring this in when I come back in again.
Okay.
It's the... bring up his records.
Okay.
On his... whatever that is.
Okay. Do you want to just bring it when you come back in and they can scan it?
Okay. Okie doke. Here you go. There you go, Sweetie. Joe.
Okay. All right. I'll call you as soon as he's done.
Yeah. Oh, those are adorable. Those two.
Yeah, they're cute.
Yeah. Bye, Joe. You're fine.
Come here, Jojo. Just for a second. Come here, buddy. Joe! Careful, please. So Drew was here. I'm basically just going to get a little bit done, then I'm going to take a break to go get him in the tub. So I'm working around that scheduled phone call.
I know, Joe.
It's okay.
Oh, Joe, I know.
He's a Shih Tzu mix named Joe, and he's hilarious. I'll probably record him, too. And get like the transition smoother when I have to pause and stuff. I'm just using my cell phone. I don't know if maybe it would benefit me to try it on a computer. The reason I did my cell phone is because every single time I get my laptop out, my 2-year-old goes ballistic. And he just sits there and he tries to grab it from me the whole time. And he hits the keyboard and it's damn near impossible to do anything. He's been like that since he was like 6 months old. He's obsessed. And like, my husband has a little wireless keyboard he uses for his tablet. He's obsessed with that too. He'll just get it down and sit and bang on it. And I've tried like giving him that while I'm on my laptop, but he knows. And he also knows where the power button is, and he likes to turn it on and off. And he thinks it's funny. You look at him, you're like, oh, Oliver, and he goes, oh, mama. Or he'll say, oops. So yeah, that's why I use my cell phone most of the time. For anything. I used to be a lot more computer savvy. Basically, before I stopped going to college, now I'm just not as good with the computers as I once was. Probably because back in the day, I didn't have a smartphone. Joe, you're okay. Tomorrow's Saturday. Surprisingly, I have no dogs on my schedule. But I'm telling you, that's freaking weird. Because Saturday's usually my busiest day. And if no one calls in before I leave today, I'm saying, nope, I'll see you. I don't get Saturdays off too often. But I have a feeling, even if I am off, I'm just going to be sitting at home. So I think we're supposed to get a snowstorm tonight with sleet. I live in a rural town, and they are terrible about plowing. Terrible. And I work 25 minutes away in the more metro area. So sometimes it's hard getting here when it's nasty out. I always make do, but I drive a tiny little Chevy Spark. I've got newish tires, so. And now I'm rambling about things no one cares about, really. Alright. So this one looks good. So we are going to take a little break so I can go give Joe his bath and have him drying while I finish rigging so he's not here for a super long time. Be back. All right. So now that Joe is in the kennel drying, we can finish up rigging. And hopefully I've got enough time before my phone call. I'm dreading that call. I hate any kind of phone call. But this one I have to argue with people on. Which I'm not good at. I'm not a confrontational person.
Hey, can I steal some of your noodles?
Sure.
Thanks.
You're on camera. Say hi.
Hi.
Say hi. Kaylee's stealing my noodles. There's mac and cheese or there's ramen.
I'm getting ramen. He'll fill me up more.
Alright.
Okay.
Oh. Hey, Kaylee. There you go. I'm feeding the staff now. Got a little food stash in here. I say it was secret, but everybody knows about it. So if anybody has any video editing software recommendations, throw that my way, I'd appreciate it. A friend of mine once, she was like, how do you use your left hand with your clippers? So I'm right-handed. And honestly, my left hand's just as natural with these as my right. I can't scissor with my left hand. It all depends on what side of the dog I'm on, which side feels better to use. I need to have surgery on this hand bad. I've had surgery on the right hand. And it still has some issues, but not as bad as it used to be. That was a couple years ago now. 3 years almost. But I've got severe nerve damage in both of my hands from a carpal tunnel. And honestly, I had that before I even started learning how to groom. I was a nerd in high school, and I was on the computer all the time. Plus homework in college and everything. No, no. I have a 5-blade and a 4-blade like this one. and they, it takes them a while to get hot when I'm not doing a mad or dog. You'll see, I've been checking it, and it's not hot. Hey, pretty, pretty. Oh, no. Okay. Ready? Ready? No. Okay. I know I'm weird. Anyone that knows me knows I'm weird. Okay, stop. Darn elbows and armpits. The crisis check is working on you. Works on some dogs, not others. Let me get this back of your foot, okay? You can tell where I had to do it shorter, but it's not going to be overly obvious because his ear will cover it. All right, we're done with the five. Yay! I'm slipping on hair. So we are going to brush his head out because Mama likes a longer head. And they like a beard on him. A huge issue. Like I said, I can't believe I saved his sister's ears yesterday. It's one of those things. I'll be mad at sections. But a whole dog, not so much. Unless it brushes out super easy, which they never do. Unless it's like a schnauzer. Oh, I know. I know. Break this one up. depends on how tolerant the dog is. Him and Keeley are both very tolerant. Certain dogs, though, they see the brush and they're like, arr! Be able to get the attachment through that side fairly easy. It says the stuff, the matting spray, and I really like it. It helps a lot. I know there's fancier things out there, but I don't want to spend the money to try them, because you get less for the price. I was out of town where you can charge a ton of money for grooming, so it's hard to buy super expensive supplies like that. And hell, they sell this stuff on Amazon. If I'm low on it before I place Orion's order, which is almost always. I even like it just for like brushing out a knot at a dog, so it makes them nice and soft. Shiny. Bathing him, and one of the girls, I had his body thinned out or whatever, and I hadn't touched his head yet. One of the girls was like, oh, you look like me in the 80s, skinny body and a big poofy head. Bud. Big poofy head. Alright. So this is 7/8 of an inch. Most dogs that I do this length on the body, I don't leave their heads that long. They like it, and it doesn't look terrible on this guy. Little dogs, though, when you leave their heads all bigger, they look like little bobbleheads. Yes, it was the same dog, and you're on camera. You're on camera.
on camera.
I've been recording his grooming. Where are you going? No, I pre-clipped him and then I saved him. You weren't here earlier. No, this is yesterday. You saw his sister.
Oh, I was going to say they look exactly alike.
Yeah, they're the same breed.
Okay.
No, she has two of these.
All right. See you later.
Yes, Mother, I didn't finish the dog I groomed yesterday. Come here and stop hanging off the table, please. Come here. Come on. Come here, please. Okay, if you want to sit there, whatever. Why? Why do you guys always have to be at the edge of the table? Like, I know what you're trying to do, so I'm gonna make it more difficult for you. That's pretty good for that flip. Riggs, let me see it. You stand up for this. Thank you. Long hair right there. Boy. poked myself pretty good with my scissors. It's gonna bleed. No, I did is poke it with tip. I think I've still got some band-aids back here for this reason. Don't mind me. Properly clean my wound once I'm done with this dog. Groomer problems. Like, I barely touched it with the tip. Well, better me than the dog, that's what I always say. I'm a klutz. Like, I seriously cut myself at least once a week. Which is stupid, but it happens.
Those noodles hit the spot.
Good. I'm glad you liked the cheap noodles. It was like $2 for that whole pack.
The whole thing? Where at?
I wanted much more than that. No, it was just at Walmart. They're cheap.
I should start having a thing in my car.
I just keep a stash for days when I don't bring something better. I make to get on my knees really. So, put it down. Scissoring on the body. Pretty good job with the clippers, which is always good. Home, and shoes. Pin him out a little more by his eyes. I don't like big poofy visors. Plus, everyone's first complaint is always they can't see, so I try to make it so that they can see for as long as possible.
I prefer eyebrows to the visor look. Maybe that's just me. In here with the short spot. Once again, not terrible. Like I notice it, but it's not overly noticeable at all. Stop. Hey. Hey. Still. Beard. A little tangles out. And on the side. Don't like it sticking out. Stop. Stop. Good boy. What are you doing? Smelling my scissors? As long as you don't lick them, they're good. Stop. I had a dog lick my scissors once. That was not okay. I mean, it was a tiny little mark. But tongues bleed forever. And then her mom goes, oh, that makes sense. She likes to lick metal. It's like, well, don't lick my sharp metal, pooch. He's a cute face. He's a cute face. Can I see your ears? Oh, I can't? I can't? Yes, I can. Yes, I can. Hey. Alright. Stop. Really? Really, that was rude. Rude. Ears are already my least favorite thing to do, and dogs never want to cooperate with them. I struggle with ears. I don't know if it's because I never went to school, so I never got proper training on ears. I just have a hard time making them completely even. But like my one doodle client, she said, she goes, well, as long as there's not an inch difference, we're good. And I was like, okay, I don't struggle that much. It's not even so much like the length that I struggle with as the like the thickness. Got some swoosh. This is why beards are annoying. There's always something in them. It's hard to get them totally even, especially like on one you've dematted. Because a lot of that thickness comes out when you're dematting with a mat splitter. You smell so good, buddy. I love this fresh and clean shampoo. I know a lot of other groomers don't. They think it smells like old people. I love it. I think it smells so good. It's with my clients and the smell, it'll last for like up to 2 weeks. On my own personal dogs, my bigger dogs, it'll last for, they'll still smell good for a good week. And like my cat I use it on, he'll smell good for 2 weeks or more. Because he's not going outside. Thing is his tail. His tail had a couple knots, but nothing too bad, which is always good. Oh, please. I don't know what it is about tails. No dog likes their tail done, especially golden retrievers. I don't know if there's golden retrievers and a Bernadoodle or not. I don't know if it's like a golden doodle mixed with a Bernese Mountain Dog, if they just do poodle Bernese Mountain. Probably depends on the doodle breeder. They're not all the same. And I've given up trying to understand. I just groomed the dogs, right, Wrigley? My dog likes her tail done. They'll try to sit. And I've got a lot of dogs that'll just twirl around the table. And that's completely ridiculous. It's like, dude, just hold still, let me get it done. I have a love-hate relationship with this bar. I bought it so that I could support some of these dogs that want to sit all the time behind and string them up, but I haven't even gotten the thing to do that yet. It's because my arms are so dang sore all the time from like holding up these big dogs. Now him I don't have to do it with. A lot of them I do. Issues with my hands and arms as it is. This gel takes a toll on you. Okay. You're almost done. Manly enough, you can pull off a sparkly winter scarf. It'll
It'll look good on you. Real men wear sparkles, right, Wrigley? Oh, so dapper.
Open here, mess my stuff.
And this goes really good with the Fresh and Clean, the For Him by Tropic Clean. Smells so good.
All right, show them you're done. So handsome. Wrigley, say bye. Shake. You're not gonna shake? You're trying to do it earlier. Bye-bye.